Let's make it together. First of all, you need to prepare all parts. Okay, let's begin. First of all, we need to download the source code file from GitHub. As you can see, there are a file, zip file. Extract all file and double-click the source code file. If you didn't install the Arduino IDE yet, please visit the link and install it. Select the Arduino Nano and select 80Mega328 old version bootloader and plug the USB cable and the new port will appear. Click that appeared new port and hit the upload button. I uploaded 3D files on the Thingiverse. You can download the files for free and the link is in the below description. I'm gonna show you how to modify a servo motor into position sensor. Basically, most servo motors have a potentiometer or encoder for getting an angle value. I'm gonna use that potentiometer. In order to use it, we need to open the case, disassemble the board, and rewire like this video. I'm in the middle of disassembling and reassembling the gears. I got rid of the third gear. Cut the wires which are connected with the motors. Now I'm using a soldering tool and detaching a board from a potentiometer. Cut the wire and prepare soldering. And put some paste and put some lead on the cable. From the very left side, red, yellow, and brown. Please make sure the direction, and I put some glue on it. We are going to do the same work for two other motors. Now let's make it the joint. All you have to do, be careful, is the location which will be connected with the Arduino. Just follow this video. By the way, all the list is in the below description and you will need to buy parts and some tools. The three motors on the left side are original motors, and the motors on the right side are modified. Be careful not to get hurt when you assemble the boards, because they are sharp. Here is one of the most important steps. Put the horn on the motors and check the available angle. As you can see, the angle is limited, so I put the horn like this. Okay, detach the horn and put the horn again and check the available angle. Keep in mind that the angular ranges of the motors must be the same. Let's assemble the joint roughly, since we may adjust it later. Looks good. Assemble the Arduino Nano and the expansion board. The right motors will be plugged into analog pins. The motor at the bottom is plugged into A0. On the other hand, the left motors will be plugged into digital pins. The motors at the bottom is plugged into pin 9. The second motors are assembled this way. Once again, the left motors are the original motors and the right motors are the motors that have been modified for potentiometers. The second motor is on pin 10. And the second potentiometer plugs into pin A1. If we plug it in the wrong direction, it could burn the board in the worst case. Please, please make sure the direction. Let's make a joint connecting the second motor and the third motor. I will assemble the joint. Assemble them so that the operating angles of both sides are the same. Turn it manually until the motor does not turn. If it does not go any further, turn it 90 degrees backward. And disassemble the horn and put it together again based on that location. Again, I'm gonna assemble roughly to make it easy to adjust later. Let's assemble the third motor. Plug the third motor to pin 11. Plug the third potentiometer into the A2. Assemble the last parts one by one. Put the USB cable into any power source and test it. Oh, it looks good. It works well. I wanted one more robot, so I made one more. With the Arduino Nano, you can build and control three robots. If you wanna make more than three units, you must use another board. The third robot will be connected with 3, 5, and 6. If you want to see more projects, please subscribe. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. I'm Untitled Chapter. Thanks for watching. See you next video.